receiver, always staying busy, he's your league leader in receiving yards.
It's the Packers and the Eagles on Sunday night.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Tonight we've got a great Sunday night matchup between the Green Bay Packers and the Eagles. Alongside my partner Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And CD, you look at the Packers in this matchup. We know how good they are throwing the football, number one in the league. But they're in for a stern test here.
Without question, because they're facing the best defensive unit in the NFL. They've got speed at every level on that side of the ball. Everyone can run, and that leads to a situation where something's got to give.
Looking to throw it. Sanders has it over the middle. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line for a big crowd. Just like that, it's a gain of 12 and a first down on their first play.
Well, it was a busy man out in the backfield a week ago. They got one early and often. I have no doubt in my mind that it'll be a big part of the game plan here as well.
Sanders, first carry of the game. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage. Looking to throw on second down. Hurts. That's a short one. Incomplete to his tight end. And that gets on after a gain of 7 to the 47. And let's see the Packers defensively 6 DBs. So a dime look on third.
Could play coverage or bring pressure.
They'll get this one complete. That's A.J. Brown. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 31-yard line. They're in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
First throw complete here to his receiver, Brown. And then running in the right side of the field, crosses right out of bounds. This duo leaped in 14 yards there. First down. Really a solid start here on the opening drive, Charles. He's now 4-4, and they're already in plus territory.
Brandon, he's been so precise to start this game, like we're watching an operation taking place right now. Master surgeon at work.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And he's going to be marked down just outside the 10. It's a second down run with Sanders. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Eighth play of this opening drive coming up. This is third down. Hurts sets up to throw it.
Throwing is Hurts.
to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
They've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there. They forced the incompletion.
So Charles, they get to the first turnover of the game, and then make it a little bit extra with a field goal.
And anytime you give the ball away, what's the first thing the coach tells his defense? Don't let them score off of this. You got to put up the ball back. In 2021, as a one NFL coach turned his defense, the firemen, go out there, guys, and don't let it put some points on the board.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Packers offense here coming back out for their second drive. They find themselves down 10-0 early after the interception on their opening drive led to a field goal.
So now they've got to pick up the mantle a little bit. You mentioned the team's down 10. They've helped contribute to that. How are they going to get their team back into this ball game? Run the offense that you think is going to be effective and execute it at a high level.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Now it's Rodgers. Crosses by and it's intercepted. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. Not the first quarter that he was hoping for. Now two interceptions.
My goodness, they find a way to compartmentalize, right? Put these behind them, have that short memory, but understand why they threw the two interceptions. They go on and usually play a pretty decent game. Other quarterbacks, they have a hard time getting past it and often put the ball up for grabs the rest of the ball game.
Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. Their dreams of an undefeated season shattered with the loss a week ago. Now look, whenever an undefeated team goes down, you always hear some say, well, they needed that. I don't know, Charles. Is that a narrative that you buy into?
Well, I haven't met a coach yet that feels like they needed that loss. You know, that's not something that they're in favor of. But I do know this. People like us, all of us in the media, constantly hammering a team that's undefeated. Hey, do you think you can do it the whole season? Can you carry it the whole way? That does wear down a group. And sometimes that loss, get us off your back, you can move forward.
Tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. On third down, they'll run into Sanders. And he's going to run into a brick wall right in the middle of the field, and I don't think he got there. Going for it with Sanders. A solid pickup of five. A very solid fourth down conversion. And defensively, pure frustration. I love those plays. Fourth and one. That's who wants it more, this time the offense.
Yeah, there's a lot of hooting and hollering in there, right? A lot of contact and a lot of collisions as they try and find some space. Who's going to drop their hips, gain leverage, and move the other side backwards? We saw it there for the offense getting it done.
On first and 10, it's Sanders looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Chris Barnes there on the stop.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Another run here with Sanders. And he'll be dropped at about the 11 after only a yard.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
I mean, or else I just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down.
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
And he's got it. And inside the five here before he's out of bounds, right at the three. They'll try and run for it. And he's in. Touchdown. single season. And the Eagles' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. So they only needed a couple of feet there on fourth down, but they got more than that in end zone as he takes this into the end zone.
And I love your description right there, right? Fourth and short. They got that. No problem. Let's go ahead and get the rest of it. Finish it off in the end zone. Touchdown. Everyone goes away happy.
Elliott on for the extra point. He's got it, and it's 17-0. So that kind of takes him into the field in 8 plays. And it was Miles Sanders who finished it off with a touchdown run.
yards.
Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10.
Hurts a handoff to Sanders.
And this has been a recurring theme tonight for sure. Nowhere to run. Back to the line of scrimmage. That's all. Officially nothing on that one. No gain. So they're left with still 10 to go on third down.
Here's Hurts to throw.
This is caught. It's caught. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. Starting to rack up the yardage here in this first half. Five catches now and a first down. They'll set up to throw. Throwing middle, and it's complete. Touchdown.
Seeing the results of the same type of work here today. These guys know each other so well that they don't even have to call the play. They can just look each other and know the route that's going to be run, and usually the connection is perfect.
Elliott now to add the extra point. And the lead is now 24.
To the 25. Aaron Rodgers and the Packer offense back out onto the field. And he'll be looking to snap a pretty unwelcome start to this ball game. Interceptions on his first three drives. They'll look to turn things around here as they start with a first down.
Shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Caught by Cobb. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. Last week, several good performances in the NFC, but he was the conference's offensive player of the week, well over 100 yards.
And just the ability to make catches, you know, that gets underplayed sometimes because we're always looking for the move or the big run, but catch the football consistently. That wraps up the yardage.
They run on first down as they get about three. Second and seven, forthcoming.
There's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It's only a three-yard run, but for both sides, they have to walk away from that field like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here. And, you know, this is going to be discussed because this is the field for the backs when they run this game. He took a pretty good shot for his efforts, but give him credit. He got to the like what I said, so hard to this defense because they've been showing their best coverages on third down. So far, only allowed one conversion on a handful of attempts. One area of their game plan that they've executed to perfection.
And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchdown. So here are the Eagles to take over. They were losers last week, dropping that game to the Indianapolis Colts. But the good news for them, they've got the lead right now and the football. First and 10. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Complete. Smith has it. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. The catch and run pays off for 29 yards. So one play and they're already just shy of midfield. Running right, here's Sanders. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line.
Now whistles and a stoppage here. Looks like one of the Eagles is in some discomfort out there. While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment.
And he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about five. The offense on third down tonight, they've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 9. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down.
The sack goes to Chris Barnes. Here's Aaron Sipos out now to punt on third down.
They punted 3 times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. This is brought in at the 21. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. The Green Bay offense ready to take over.
And Charles, you look at these two teams, these are those kind of litmus test games in the second half of the season that if you're a coach or player, you can either really look forward to them or really dread them, depending on your point of view.
And if you're dreading them, you're not going to go very far in the playoffs. You need to look forward to these kind of games because here we've got two division leaders, both real contenders for the NFC title. And you're right, you love to have easy games on your schedule, but you need some games like this to toughen you up a bit and ensure that you're ready for the shock of playoff football.
And he'll be brought down right at the 35-yard line.
A gain of 5. First down, Green Bay.
Now a first down carry by Jones.
He'll work his way up the middle for a gain of 4 on second down.
Themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. And the Eagles with a battle of 16 yards on third down. Rodgers down to throw. Another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 24-yard line. Rodgers with a give to Taron Jones. And the running lanes non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring him second and 11.
How do you feel it's still committed to running the football, especially on the running down? Just haven't had a lot of success just yet.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. And he's gonna go down. This defense just seems to be playing with so much confidence right now.
They really are. They're on their toes, and they're getting at them.
Badgley able to punch this one through, and they get a little bit closer here as the lead's down to three touchdowns. Maybe a moral victory of sorts. They're on the board here late in the first half, but this offense just hasn't looked that sharp.
Yeah, but at least they got the 3 points, right? At least have something to, quote-unquote, hang their hats on and maybe feel a little bit better about themselves as they head to the half.
And this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. In the process of that kick return, it appears we had an injury. The medical staff is going to come out here and take a look, and we will take a short break. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And now consider the lead. The question is, how much is good enough? Are you going for more?
I see it. There's never enough.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Back to throw here. And he will not throw it away. He goes out of bounds, well shy of the line of scrimmage, so that's a sack. It's a loss of 4 on the first down play.
So when the defense complains about having to do pursuit drills in the heat of training camp, plug in this play. Excellent pursuit. Force the quarterback out of the pocket. He ends up trying to run for it. Instead, he goes out of bounds and loses yardage. That goes down as a sack for the defense.
Jamie completion results there at 9 yards. And it brings up 3rd and 5 now. And that will be incomplete. 4 ticks left here on the clock.
Nice call by the defense there on third down. Just from the field with extra defensive backs in their dime package. Nowhere to go with the football. Forces the incompletion.
And now the half not quite over yet. This is a live football on a miss. He's past the 30. Past midfield. Look out. 30. 10. 5. And he's going to score. Touchdown! No time remaining, and this is going to count. And that is obviously the danger, Charles, of a long field goal attempt.
What teams are doing now is not just putting their field goal block unit on. They may change it out and go punt return because you have better guys on the field who are able to stay on their feet and block in case that kick is missed. And that's what we saw there. The big return after the long missed field goal.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome in, everyone, to our EA Sports Halftime Report. Let's get you caught up on what's going on around the NFL. We'll get things started up at Ford Field in Detroit, where you see the final score there. Josh Allen leading the way in the victory with 3 touchdown passes. From there, let's head to AT&T Stadium as we check out the Cowboys at home in Dallas. And they were winners in that one over the visiting New York Giants. Dak Prescott, terrific in the win as his guys up their mark to 7-4 with the victory. And then finally, a Cyber Monday edition of Monday Night Football as the final game of November is the Steelers and the Colts from Lucas Oil Stadium. Now to a check on the next-gen stats in that first half for the Packers. And they didn't get a whole lot accomplished through the air in those first 2 quarters of play. They'll need to up their game if they want to rally all the way back. Meanwhile, for the Eagles, we check out their numbers on the ground as they'll try to keep the momentum going into the second half. Both these teams making their final halftime adjustments. We're just about ready to get back to football. So for the call of the second half, we get back up to Philadelphia and Brandon Gott.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Packers set to get the football first, and they are trailing on the scoreboard as we resume action. Ready for the third quarter. Take it in at the three. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. Now Aaron Rodgers and the offense heading back onto the field. And he's got to be wondering what happened in that first half. Three interceptions, very uncharacteristic.
And even the great ones go through phases like this, like what we just saw. And most of them, they have such a mental capacity to throw it out and essentially start over. I think that's where he's headed now.
He's got his opportunity to throw it out. Let's see how he does. On first down, Rodgers got his man complete over the middle. That's Watkins. So they'll get eight out of that completion. And that'll bring up a second down in just a couple.
Brings up second and two at the 32-yard line.
And Rodgers, he's got Tonyan complete over the middle. Now it looks like we'll get a timeout, and we will. We've got an injured Packer on the field. Hopefully, obviously, nothing serious here. Medical staff, though, going to take a peek, and we'll take a break.
Extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, the offense can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. Rodgers' throw is taken in by Jones, and he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
Well, they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
Throwing on first down is Rodgers. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43. Rodgers again now. This is complete to Watkins on the slant. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 25-yard line. Give him 18 on that play, and Green Bay has the first as well. An inside give to Jones. Down to about the 23.
But it's not time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the hole and run off a bunch more plays.
And this time they were ready for him as they stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for him. It's the limit.
Reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. That is caught. It's the tight end Tonyan. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, he just did the tip of the ball across the plane. He's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with first and goal.
First and goal, they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. And they'll turn their power game to try to get in. And he tries to power through, but he will not get back to the line of scrimmage. They've been in the red zone three times, and it's yielded just 3 points. Can they find the end zone here on second and goal? And he's got it. It's caught for the Packers touchdown. Robert Tonyan, a 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Packers are back within a score. That's a score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
You know, there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And that cuts the lead to 24-17. So that one, a long 11-play drive. And it was Robert Tonyan capping it all off on the touchdown grab. Following the touchdown, Badgley out there to kick it away. And from back there, Wise Booth will just sit on this one. And it'll come out to the 25. So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. Charles, they still have the lead despite their defense giving up a touchdown on the previous possession. And even though they have that lead, it feels like a back-and-forth ball game where to try to get momentum back, maybe they need at least three here on this drive.
I think you're right about that, Brandon, because your game plan doesn't change. I do believe your urgency does because of the last score that went against your team. So what you want to do now is have your own drive and try and make sure that momentum stays in your camp.
And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. Kenny Clark racking up sack number 12 for him on the year.
I'm sure a lot of time was spent in the locker room, Charles, talking with his defense about setting a tone here in the third quarter when you're down on the scoreboard. Sack like that, maybe that can get him going.
Yeah, you have to believe exactly what you just said, and they got together and said, let's be some change agents here. Let's
under pressure again, and down he goes again. The safety blitz staged to perfection that time as they sack him for a loss of six.
So that time, Charles, a quarterback helpless really in the pocket in the face of a pass rush like that. They were on him instantly.
Yeah, that's when we turn to your wife and say, guys, can I get a little help here? And you have to ask politely because remember, they're blocking for you the entire game. But as a quarterback, you've also got to have the clock running in your head when you need to get rid of the football. But this time, he had no chance. They were on him instantly.
And the next-gen stat's going to show just how much time he had to make a decision, and it's not much. 3 seconds, the final clocking. So after that sack, Hurts and the Eagles, tough spot here, third and long.
They'll look to throw here. And that would be incomplete.
And that's a really good job there offensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the three and out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
So possession goes over here on the punt. That will come the offense as they take over. He threw his league best 35th touchdown pass of the year on that last drive. And they'll start here on first and 10. Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 on their side of midfield at the 47. Throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete.
That no command that time, man. They're putting too much heat on it. Don't step on it.
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now it's Rodgers. Eagle pressure. Too much this time. Fletcher Cox has been doing this
Rodgers now after the sack. He'll lead the pack up on third and long. Now Rodgers. And that is incomplete.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you play man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
This is taken around the 12. It's a 4-yard return following a punt of 39. And the Eagles will have it taking over first and 10. And out now come the Eagles. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is, can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
They'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive. Up the middle they go with Sanders. Room here to run. And they'll get him down here at the 23.
Run a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
They'll try and run for it with Sanders, and he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third.
Sometimes with a running game, you just got to stick with it. This is the third quarter, no time to panic. Also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Yeah, he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down.
4 yards on the pickup. Second and six.
Looking to throw again on second down. Hurts to the sideline. Wow, doesn't get a lot out of it. But he is able to keep the feet in bounds. Hurts. Toward the sideline, and will have the first down. Good catch. He's able to keep the feet in bounds. It's a pickup of six.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has another body control to get his feet down in bounds. Toe tap it and drag it to make sure he gets it done.
A couple of first downs have him to the 40 now on first and 10. Hurts sets up to throw it. He's going deep for Brown. The guy is made complete. And he's going to be brought down at about the 16. Excellent execution, and now they're set up nicely.
Are they ever red zone? I wonder what the next play call is going to be, because after a big play like that, a lot of teams like to use momentum to launch another one.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. On the draw, here's Sanders. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. The defense showing some anger after giving up the big play. This time they'll lose one or two.
I think it's pretty evident. We can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and he's going to be sacked back at the 23-yard line. The safety blitz staged to perfection that time as they sack him for a loss of six. So after that sack, Hurts and the Eagles, tough spot here, third and long. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's the Eagles in possession of the football and leading this one as we get ready to start the final quarter. They'll wind up with 17 on that one, but they're still a bit short here for fourth.
Boy, they had a lot of real estate to make up there, but what a big-time play for them. Nice completion, excellent game, and now they're fourth and manageable.
Just a little short, though, with that marker. On fourth down, they'll try and run for it. And he has first and goal. 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. They'll run with Sanders. And now a little out there. He does get a couple, taking it for the five down to the three. So the ball position now at the three. Here's second and goal. Sanders going to be hit and met at the line of scrimmage. Taking him down at the three. Nothing doing there as the 13th play of the drive proves to be unlucky. They'll look to throw on third and goal. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. So it's been a long drive. They've held the ball for quite a while. Now what do you do here?
Well, to me, at this stage, after this drive, this close to the goal line, 3 points would be a letdown. I'm going for it here.
Touchdown! Him in the passing game.
And they put a lot of pressure on a defensive coordinator and defense, don't they? Because they're used to him as a runner. But it turns out he's just as dangerous as some of those receivers, and he showed it right there. You don't pay enough attention to him defensively, he makes you bad.
Just better for him. Sometimes it just doesn't
Giants on their heels. Two first downs in a row, and now a pickup of eight. From the two now, second and goal. Sanders again. And he's in for his touchdown. Season, Charles, and he continues to put together. That's now 25 rushing touchdowns on the year. That's getting into some very rarefied territory.
Yeah, it made you and I do a little extra homework probably this way in anticipation because
out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
Yeah, so you're right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are starting to think about it. And get better for the next time. This, that uses motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
Obviously, he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Vontae Maddox. And he takes this one. Eagles defense gets a pick 16. Little choice, Charles, but to go for it right there. And that puts it to the icing on the cake.
Yeah, you don't know how many more possessions you're going to get. So really, you're almost at the point of no option. Have to go for it. Bottom line, though, is defenders know that as well. They know you've got to throw the football. Had the right defense call, they will make a nice play on the ball. And that's our shot.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Green Bay offense ready to take over. And you can sort of sense their dejection. That last pick six put the icing on the cake, so to speak, in what has been a rough go for them. Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. After the pick six, they go right back to the air. He finds his man complete. That's Watkins. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Throwing now is Rodgers. That's Tonyan bringing in the quick throw. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Here's Rodgers. He's got Watkins on the out route. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Now it looks like we'll get a timeout, and we will. We've got an injured Packer on the field. So as the medical staff takes a look, we'll step aside. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. And one more time, that's Watkins. And they'll work this down inside the 30. But this game well in hand. Perhaps we're seeing the coverage lighten up a little bit as they got burned there a bit for first down.
But we certainly know the coach isn't happy along the sideline, because he certainly wants them to finish this one out the way they started it. He doesn't want to give up any soft completions, no late points. He wants his lead to stay right where it is.
And he'll be taken down at about the 22-yard line. Throwing again on second down, Rodgers. Being chased out left. And he'll just get rid of it.
That incompletion is not a surprise. The way that this one has gone and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
The easy part of the game for them, because just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of covers.
Packers on the pick up the first. And the Eagles defense are able to hold. Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their own 21. They'll start with a handoff to Sanders. And they'll get 8 out of this before being stopped at the 28. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. Line of scrimmage, the 28 now, as they come up on second and a couple. Another run here with Sanders. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 55 rushing yards rushing for him. Now to come, the touchdown runs to boot. On first and 10, it's Sanders. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. 8 yards the gain on that last run here. Second and a couple. A handoff to Sanders. And he'll get it out to midfield. It's a gouge spot right at midfield at the 50. Now, what a first down pickup of 8. They'll run with Sanders up the middle. And he's got a run. And pretty good burst right there as he takes this down to the 33. 17 yards and a first down for Felling. Sanders here as they run out of the gun. And he'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7.
I know that every now and then we get those meetings with coaches, and you almost want to roll your eyes when it's talking about staying on schedule when you're moving the football. But would you say a 7-yard run is ahead of schedule?
Fourth quarter with a lead, you love that.
No doubt about it, because staying on schedule is trying to get.
And he will get into the end zone. It's a touchdown. This thing is on. They said before the game that they were going to try and execute every second in this contest. I guess that that was taken literally, because here they are in the final moments of the fourth, putting another touchdown on the board, Charles, to add to this big lead.
Not a big believer, 110%, but it certainly applies here, doesn't it? Because some guys just can't go with lots. As long as this time they've done the climb, they're going to push you hard to get to the end zone. They don't want to kill them off behind the touchdown. And this one finishes the game.
And this one's going to be covered up by the Packers' hands team.
Illegal touching. Offense.
Yeah, you got to wait until that ball goes 10 yards. They did not. They hit it before, and that draws the flag every time.
And there's no doubt in my mind that converting an onside kick has never been tougher in the NFL with the new rules. So trying to get it to 10 yards, timing up perfectly, that's tough enough to begin with. But when you go ahead and grab it before it goes, you got no shot.
And a throw in zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.